Thank you, Madam Chair and Commissioners. This is a request to amend the previously approved PD site plan on Valdel, known as the Valdel Villas, to allow for additional density, approximately 3 lots here. As well as to remove a note on the PD site plan that says all buildable lots are sized appropriately for a house to fit on without administrative waivers. Because this is a PD amendment for planning commission. Redwood Environment did submit a request to the Army Corps of Engineers to determine if the wetlands depicted here on the previously approved site plan were under their jurisdiction. The Army Corps of Engineers did submit that no, these wetlands are not under the Army Corps' jurisdiction. And a quote from their letter that the placement of dredged or fill material into these wetlands would not require prior Department of Army Corps authorization pursuant to Section 404 of the Clean Water Act. So again, the Army Corps has said this is not wetlands under our jurisdiction, Lowndes County, and is now up to you to make any determination there whether or not. Given that, the County Engineering Department has put forth the following measures, and I'll read them for the minutes. For all newly planted lots that are adjacent to wetlands, floodplain, drainage ditches, or detention ponds, the following shall be provided. A benchmark shall be established at the front property corner of every lot. A high water mark, base flood elevation, or hydraulic analysis performed shall establish the 100-year flood elevation established. A minimum finished floor elevation shall be established for the lot in question, a minimum of 2 feet above the established 100-year elevation. A minimum of 2 soil borings on opposite sides of the proposed foundation shall be completed to determine the seasonal high water table. If the seasonal high water table is less than 1 foot from the bottom of the footer elevation, a subsurface drainage system shall be designed by the professional engineer who is responsible for development of the subdivision and construction plans and shall be installed. Before any inspections are performed and signed off on, a registered land surveyor must certify that the proposed finished floor is at or above the minimum finished floor elevation established on the final plat. And again, those are conditions of the engineering department for all newly established lots here in the new wetlands, including the wetlands on the property.
Necessarily on this property for a whole period.
That was put on for this reason.
So just for this property.
And moving forward.
That's what I was for that.
Yeah, for this one and all additional properties moving forward here. What was on the property needs 6, I think, conditions for the county engineering department before they would sign off on the plat.
So just to clarify, the wetlands were not delineated, but the engineers or the Army Corps of Engineers just is not.
The wetlands were delineated by Red Oak LLC to show the wetlands, and then the Army Corps of Engineers said, we determined these wetlands are not in our jurisdiction to make a ruling. Therefore, it falls to Lowndes County to make a ruling on how to best answer.
I'm just curious, how do they determine what's in their jurisdiction? When it has a case for 45 minutes that was in their jurisdiction, it threw a rock and hit it.
It is my understanding, after talking with the engineering department, that the Army Corps of Engineers jurisdiction now only includes wetlands with an inflow and outflow. This being an isolated pocket of wetlands, essentially a low area, is no longer under their jurisdiction to give guidance on. That was something that was completely changed in the Trump administration's guidance to the EUD, and that's the regulations.
So they can just fill the problem.
Based on that letter from the Army Corps of Engineers.
All right, any more questions for staff before we open it up? All right, is there anyone here tonight wishing to speak on behalf of this request? Please come forward. Anyone wishing to speak on behalf? Alright, is there anyone here tonight wishing to speak against this request? Please come forward. Anyone wishing to speak against? Alright, if not, I'll turn it back over to the commissioners for any final discussion.
Just one question for JJ, if necessary. Sure. So at the bottom of your application page here, these would be considered conditions.
Correct. My condition is not, these are, well, they are conditions, but they have to be.
There would have to be conditions not only for the approved site plan, but just for all for the final plan.
Okay, but we should consider them as conditions that must be followed.
Correct.
Okay. they're not for us to consider tonight.
But is these lots are for us to consider?
The lots are for consideration for the approved PUD site plan. Now, in order for those to be approved, they'd have to submit a final plat. Those conditions there would be put on the final plat.
Okay.
So.
That are already in place.
So we're just asked to consider.
The amendment.
The amendment to the PUD.
Correct, correct, okay. Which is the addition of these lots and the removal of that note seven narrative that says all lots.
Understood. Okay.
I am just presenting this to say.
Thank you for that clarification. Yes. All right.
Madam Chair.
Yes, Commissioner Bailey.
County case REZ 2021-13 about Valdale Villa. They are seeking a PD with PD amendments, and they are listed on our case this evening. And with those, they are looking to remove number 7 on the original plat. And if all that is clear, I make a motion that we approve the request this evening.
Okay. Have a motion to approve. Have a second.
Second.
Second by Commissioner Hightower. Any discussion on the motion? All right, all those in favor of the motion to approve, please raise your right hand. And all those against, and the motion carries. All right,